In past episodes, we learned that plates are fragments of Earth's lithosphere. And there are two different kinds of plates, oceanic and continental. Plates move independently and interact to shape landscapes and cause earthquakes and volcanic eruptions. Can you guess how many different types of movement there can be? The answer is three. Plates can move towards each other at convergent plate boundaries, away from each other at divergent plate boundaries, and slide past each other at transform boundaries. Plate boundaries have the most earthquakes and volcanoes. In this episode, we're going to focus on convergent plate boundaries. A convergent plate boundary is the meeting place of two plates converging, which just means moving towards each other. Where they meet, one of the plates will sink or subduct beneath the other. There are two different types of convergent margins, depending on whether the subducting plate is continental or oceanic. If a continental plate subducts beneath another continental plate, we have a collision zone, where continental crust is folded, faulted, and pushed under the other plate, creating mountain ranges like the Himalayas. These mountain ranges are the highest places on planet Earth. In contrast, where an oceanic plate subducts beneath another continental or oceanic plate, an oceanic trench forms. Trenches are the deepest places on Earth's surface. Let's talk about the subduction of oceanic crust first, and then we'll talk about continental collision zones. There are three important features of convergent margins that subduct oceanic plates: trenches, earthquakes, and volcanoes. Trenches are where the oceanic plate begins to subduct. The deepest earthquakes in the Earth happen beneath convergent margins. These earthquakes define an inclined seismic zone that tells us where the subducted oceanic plate is. A chain of volcanoes is also found above the subduction zone. These volcanoes are called an island arc if they are found in the ocean, like the islands of Japan, the Philippines, or Indonesia. Continental margin volcanoes also make high mountains on land, like the Andes of South America or the Cascade volcanoes of Oregon and Washington. Convergent margins subducting oceanic crust are especially important around the Pacific Ocean, and the many volcanoes associated with these are part of what is called the Ring of Fire. Regions around convergent plate margins can be dangerous because of the strong earthquakes and violent volcanic eruptions. Very powerful earthquakes can happen in the subduction zone, including the 2011 earthquake that struck Japan. Sometimes these strong earthquakes happen under the ocean, and this can cause a devastating tsunami. The second type of convergent boundary is when two continental plates meet, causing a continental collision. Remember, the continental plates are lighter and thicker, so it is really hard for continental plates to sink into the mantle. Have you ever tried to push a ball underwater? The ball will rise to the surface and float because it's filled with air, which is less dense than water. Just like the ball in the swimming pool, the lower density continental plates are not easy to subduct into the mantle. Instead of going down, the continental crust literally bunches up, thickening and folding to create spectacular mountain ranges, like the Himalayas or the Alps. Mount Everest is the highest mountain in the world and formed as a result of the collision between the Indian and Asian continental plates. These mountain ranges are not only high, but are some of the most beautiful places on Earth. In the next episode, we visit spreading centers and see how plates are born. See you next time when we will talk about divergent plate boundaries.